Hi, I'm Pradeepan Ravi, and I'm working for an organization called CVDEP India. CVDEP is an organization based in Bangalore in India, working on workers' rights and corporate accountability. Today, India has reported at least 14,000 cases of coronavirus, and 480 people have died. As a measure to contain the spread of the virus, the government had announced a complete lockdown from 22nd March till 14th April, which is now extended to 3rd May. This has come as a huge shock to workers across the country, mainly because all manufacturing units and commercial establishments have been closed down following the lockdown announcement. The worst affected are the migrant workers. Most of them are stranded in the cities where they are working. The railways and road transportation are suspended, and which means that the workers will not be able to return to their hometowns or villages. And the main problem is that many of these workers are left without food and shelter. The plight of the local workers is also no different. In the state of Tamil Nadu, more than a million workers are working in the leather sector, and most of them are casual laborers working on a temporary basis. And we also have a large number of home-based workers who are mainly women. And the lockdown means these workers are out of job and they have no means to earn a livelihood. And these workers also have fear about job security, mainly because the leather industry itself is going through a difficult phase because of the disruptions in the global and domestic supply chains. These are also workers without any social security or adequate savings to tide over the situation. So these workers are struggling to make ends meet, and they require support to meet their basic needs. The government has announced some relief measures, some assistance to poor families to tide over the situation, but it largely remains inadequate, and workers are also finding it difficult to access these benefits. Trade unions and organizations like us are taking efforts to reach out to the workers and provide them the basic needs such as cooked food and dry ration, etc. But still the gap remains huge. We need more support and contributions to reach out to maximum number of workers and their families. Thank you.